Thank you, Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, I have the great pleasure this wonderful night to introduce to us the humble servant of God, Reverend Father Anthony Maddo. God bless you, Maddo, as the Holy Spirit has already filled you for the work he has called you to do. In Jesus' name, amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, I welcome you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Amen. I would like us to reflect today on God's broken silence in our conditions. God's broken silence in our conditions. There are times in our life when you think that God has been silent, he does not want to answer your prayers. There are times in your life where you think that everything is static. There are times in your life where you think that God does not exist. There are conditions you find yourself in life and you think that God has no ear to listen to you again. There are times in your condition in life when you are losing it, when you think like you no longer want to pray again. Today is your day. God has broken his silence in your condition. God has remembered you. All your groanings in the night, all your sleepless nights, all your prayer points that you think that are dormant, they are alive. Go and look at Book of Tobit, chapter 12, from verse 12 following. One of the archangels said, I am one of the archangels that not only presents your petitions before the Lord, I read it out before the Lord. God is talking to you today. I would like us to reflect on the book of Isaiah, chapter 62, from verse 1, following, up to verse 12. Isaiah 62, from verse 1, says, about Zion, I will not be silent. About Jerusalem, I shall not rest until saving justice down to her like a bright light, and her salvation like a blazing torch. Look at that. About you and your condition, God is talking to you today. He will no longer be silent. Claim it today. God is talking to you. God will no longer be silent in your condition. God will no longer be silent in your condition. That's your sickness. God will no longer be silent about it. That's your business. God will no longer be silent about it. That's your business. God will no longer be silent about it. That's your joblessness. God will no longer be silent about it. God has come to liberate you from that captivity. It has lingered enough. And God is talking to you. You. You think that God will not fish you out? Yeah, he knows. He knows that you have been knocking at his door. Yes, in the Bible, Matthew chapter 7, verse 7, he said, ask. You have been asking. And today, God is saying to you, you shall receive. You have been seeking. Today, God is telling you, you shall find. You have been knocking, and God is telling you today, the door will be open for you. Say amen to that. Let me tell you, my dear brothers and sisters, sometimes God's silence is also an answer. When God is silent in your condition, God is waiting for a moment, a defining moment, to give you what you want. Sometimes you may want a job now, and God is telling you, be patient, my dear brother. Be patient, my dear child. Be patient, my dear sister. That your enemies are still there. When God knows that He will give you that thing you're asking for, He will make sure that you will be okay and protected. Think about Jesus, Joseph, and Mary. When Herod was looking for the child Jesus, he told them to run to Egypt. And when they ran to Egypt, they were safe. What is your own Egypt when you are in a difficult condition? Remember that God is God. When the time for Jesus and Mary and Joseph to come out, when the time came, Jesus also was safe. You know, he was God-man. But God was protecting his family. God will protect your family. God gave the message that Herod that was pursuing them will one day die. And they will be safe. And when Herod died, the message came to Joseph and Mary. Your enemy is dead. You know, sometimes when we think that God does not do his own work, remember that when we were in our mother's womb, we never taught our parents how to feed us. We never taught our parents how to guide and protect us. We were very humble and subservient. We are very submissive. But when we grow up, when we are born, when we open our eyes, we think that we are wiser than our parents. My dear brothers and sisters, we have to be patient sometimes with God. Not that we shall not be telling him something. Tell God something. Oh yeah, tell God something. But when you are telling God something, have strong faith. At the back of your mind, have strong faith. But have tête-à-tête with God. God wants us to speak. But we have to speak with faith. Not just talking. We have to speak with faith. Faith in the living God. Our God is not dead. Our God is alive and active. Hebrews 4:12. The word of God is alive and active. Jesus is my power. Jesus is my strength. Oh, Jesus is my life. Jesus is my health. Jesus is my power. Jesus is my strength. Oh, Jesus is my life. Jesus is my health. Jesus is my power. Jesus is my strength. Oh, Jesus is my life. Jesus is my health. When you think that your condition is getting worse and worse and worse, remember that in that condition you are, that God is in your condition. Even the dead person, God answered his or her prayers. No condition is greater than God. No condition is greater than God. When God allows certain things to happen in your life, it's not because the condition is bigger than God. No. It's just not because God says, it is the way I want it to happen. When you look at Book of Proverbs, chapter 16, verse 7. Book of Proverbs, chapter 16, verse 7, it says, let Yahweh be pleased with someone's way of life. And he makes that person's very enemies to be that person's friend. When God is pleased with you, He will make your enemies to be your friend. When God is pleased with your way of life, even your attackers, even your oppressors, He will use them to your own advantage. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 7. We shall be looking at Proverbs today as we discuss along. But look at that. God, when He is pleased with you, He will break His silence. How are we to be pleasing to God? By keeping His precepts. By bonding with the Lord. Gospel of John chapter 15, verse 1 following. You have to abide with the Lord. Because you are a divine instrument. If you continue to bond with the Lord, God will continue to walk with you. And you will continue to have everlasting dominion. When you have the divine dynamis, nothing will be shaken in your life. Even when you are sick, even when your condition seems that you, as if to say nothing can happen in your condition, God is still with you. God is still with you. God is still with you. Don't lose your bearing. If you look at Zechariah, book of Zechariah, chapter 8, verse 23, he says, Yahweh Sabaoth says, in those days, 10 men from nations of every language will take a Jew by a sleeve and say, we want to go with you, since we have learned that you are God. He's a God of miracle. That your God is with you. So don't be surprised. Even your enemies who would like to touch your cloak, would like to touch your hand, and say, oh, surely this woman is a child of God. Surely this man is a man of God. Don't be surprised. Those people that are gossiping against you, they know the stuff you are made of. Look at book of Zechariah, chapter 8, verse 23. And see the pronouncement of God in your life. Such days will also come to your own lifetime. What happened in 10 men from nation of every language will happen in your own time and in your life and in your condition. The Lord has answered by fire is with you. And you are on fire with the Holy Ghost. The angels are on guard with you. Because your house is on an angelic zone. God has broken His silence today in your condition. God has broken His silence today in your condition. God has broken His silence today in your condition. Psalm 103 verse 2 says, never forget all God's acts of kindness. Sometimes we forget. We only remember the things that are not going well in our life. We have to remember the goodness of the Lord. Psalm 103 verse 3 says, God forgives all your offenses and cures all your diseases. Tell God how good He was to you in the past and still in the present, giving you life. That will help you to keep bonding with the Lord without losing your bearing. In Psalm 103 verse 5, God, you see that God contents you with good things. All your life renews your youth like an eagle. When you are bonding with the Lord, God will continue to renew you. God will continue to make you to look like a youth. Anybody that sees you will no longer say, you're aging. They will say you are getting younger and younger in the Lord. But when you allow the condition or the predicament you find yourself to eat you up, even as a young boy, as a young man, as a young girl, you'll be looking old because you have abandoned yourself to the condition you find yourself. You have to live above God. Don't allow your condition to eat you up. You, I'm talking to you. Yes. God is ministering to you today. Don't allow your condition to eat you up. Don't allow your predicament to eat you up. God has broken his silence. God has come to redeem you. He's your redeemer. Remember Isaiah 62 from verse 1 today. About you, I will not be silent. About Jerusalem, I will not rest. Claim it today. For about your condition, God will never be silent again. About your children, God will never be at rest. You may be worried about your children, especially the girls. You may think that they will not marry. You see them aging. Let me tell you. Sometimes we worry a lot and forget that God gave us those children as gifts. Jeremiah chapter 31 verse 13 says, the young girl will then take pleasure in the dancing, and young men and old alike, I shall change their mourning into gladness, comfort them, give them joy after their troubles. Sometimes we are worried and worried and worried, both young and old. But God is beating the song that will put us into dance. We take a regular step with the Lord and brighten our face and our eyes to receive divine blessing and grace. Book of Proverbs chapter 27 verse 2 will say, let someone else sing your praise. Not you with your mouth. Some people will be singing your praise in Jesus' name. Many people that have been seeing you in that condition will say, wow, this man, wow, this young lady, wow. What has happened? She's so refreshed. He is so refreshed. What's going on with him? What is going on with her? Maybe someone is coming. Oh, praise God. People will be singing your praise. You will no longer be singing the praise of yourself. People will see what you think that they are not seeing. People will hear what you think that they are not hearing. And they will be singing your praise because they are seeing God's work in your life. They are seeing God's work because God has broken his silence. When God breaks his silence, many things will be happening. Many good things will be happening in your life. When God breaks his silence, you will receive divine blessing. You will no longer feel abandoned. When you think that God is silent in your life, take up your pen and write Psalm 44. Book of Psalm 44. Book of Psalm 44. Talk to God with Book of Psalm 44. When you think that God is still silent in your life. But today I'm telling you that you have to claim this divine breakthrough for you. Psalm 103 verse 13 says, as tenderly as a father treats his children, so Yahweh treats those who fear him. In fear and trembling, you follow God. With respect and worship and adoration, you gain divine favor. God has broken his silence. and God will never look back again. In Psalm 91, from verse 5 to 6, it says, you need not fear the terror of the night. Because many people are afraid of their dreams. Many people are afraid, even at night, of their shadows. And Psalm 91 from verse 5 to 6 saying, you need not fear the terror of the night. Yes, I know that there are a lot of things happening in the night. But the Bible is telling you, you need not fear the terror of the night. No matter where the terror is coming, know that God is a great warrior too. He championed the Israelites over Pharaoh and his warriors. He is a great conqueror. He knows how to handle the wicked around you. He knows how to handle your condition and your predicament. That's why he's telling you not to fear the arrows that flies by day, the bullets of the enemies, the incantations and libations of the enemies. You shall not be afraid of them. For when they are doing their incantation and libations, you have to cancel it too. But praying is in and out of season. For Psalm 91 tells us today that the plagues of stocks, the stocks in the dark, will not touch us. And the scourge that wreaks havoc at the high noon will not touch us. Because our God is there. Our God is God. Sometimes God is silent. And we think that God has abandoned us. Proverbs chapter 17, verse 28 is telling us, even the fool who keeps silent is considered wise when he closes his lips. He is deemed intelligent. People will think that he is intelligent because he's keeping silent. Sometimes we have to learn how to be cool, even when things are going bad. Because not everybody would like to hear that everything is good for you. Sometimes you have to be reserved and only reveal your condition to men and women of God. When you talk too much about your condition, sometimes your enemies will know what is going on in your life. Don't tell your condition that you are weak. Tell your condition how big your God is. God is alive. And God is talking to your condition today. Psalm 37 verse 7 says, be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Fret not yourself over the one who prosper in his way. You never know what is going on in that person's life. Be still before the Lord. Psalm 37 verse 7. And book of Job, chapter 29, verse 21 says, men, listen to me. You have to wait and keep silent for my counsel. Children of God, listen to God. Wait on the Lord. And keep silent so as to be able to receive his counsel. Remember, book of Habakkuk, chapter 2, verse 20 says, the Lord is always in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent before him. When the Lord is ministering to your condition, and you are not following the rhythm, the monotonous rhythm of the Paternoster of God, you will not even know when God is ministering to your own condition. You have to talk to God in faith. You have to talk to God in faith. You have to be silent in faith. Just to receive that divine award in faith. God has broken his silence. Book of Proverbs, chapter 16, verse 24 says, kindly words are honeycomb, sweet to the taste, wholesome to the body. Even when your family is in tough situation, and you think that it will no longer hold, the center cannot hold, use kind words to one another. Listen to God in silence. Talk less, and pray more. Talk less, and pray more. Talk less. And pray more. Proverbs chapter 16 verse 20 says, whoever listens closely to the word finds happiness. Whoever trusts Yahweh is blessed. Book of Proverbs chapter 16 verse 20. Whoever listens closely to the word of God finds happiness. And whoever trusts Yahweh is blessed. My happiness is here. I can feel it now. It's all over me. Hallelujah, amen. My happiness is here. I can feel it now. It's all over me. Hallelujah, amen. My happiness is in the Lord. My happiness is in the Lord. The happiness of my family, my happiness is in the Lord. It's all over me. Hallelujah, amen. When you look at Book of Proverbs, chapter 16, verse 20, you'll be able to understand why I'm singing about this happiness. Whoever listens closely to the word of God finds happiness. Whoever trusts Yahweh is blessed. When you don't trust God, how can you receive blessings from him? When the word of God is spoken and you're not happy, what else can give you joy? For the word of God is alive and active. It has to reactivate your activity in life. We have to seek for the word of God in the scripture to reactivate us, to renew us, to strengthen us, to empower us and embolden us and prepare us for action. God is alive in us. God is with you. Don't lose hope. God has broken his silence. Isaiah 55 verse 6 says, seek God when he is still around you. Call him while he is still near. Verse 7 says, let the wicked abandon his way, and the evil one his thoughts. When we are seeking the Lord in faith, God is with us. When you are seeking the Lord in faith, God is with us. In Isaiah 55 verse 8 says, my ways are not your ways. My thoughts are not your thoughts. That's why sometimes we think that we have to teach God certain things. Know that God is God. God has broken his silence. And if you look at Isaiah 55 verse 10, it says, as the rain and snow come down from the sky and don't return before having watered the earth that lies in it and making it germinate to provide seed for the sower and food to eat. So it is with the word of God. So it is with the word that goes forth from the mouth of God. It will not return to me unfulfilled or before having carried out my good pleasure and the things that it's supposed to do or to achieve. God is with you. God has broken silence. Remember this. God is with you. God has broken his silence. God has not abandoned you. He listens. He knows your condition. I can't stop loving you, Jesus, in my life. I can't stop loving you, Jesus, in my life. God is everything for us. God is our everything. He has broken his silence. He's supposed to be happy today. Because God is with you. Because God is with you. God is with you. God is with your family. That's your condition. That's your condition. God is ministering to you. That's your condition. You are talking to you. That's your condition. That's your condition. God is ministering to you. Hey! Wake up. And receive divine blessing. Stop crying. Cry no more. God has established his banner with you. That your business will flourish. That your sickness will go away. All your aches and pains. God is ministering to your weak nerves. God is ministering to your weak nerves and arteries and so on. Remember, he is the potter, we are the clay. God is going through your brain. God is going through your central nervous system. God is going through your heart, your eyes and arteries and so on. God is ministering to your kidney and liver now. Hey, child of God, God has broken silence. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing, child of God. Open your hands and mouth to say amen to all this divine proclamation today. God is ministering to your cancer. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. God has spoken. Child of God. God is ministering to your daughters. They will receive their divine husbands. For God has ministered to them. God has remembered you. Receive your divine breakthrough. You'll never be alone again. God is ministering to you. Many people will sing your praise. They will no longer gossip against you. You are the son of Zion. Remember Isaiah 62 today saying, for Zion's sake, you will never be silent again. You are the daughter of Zion and sons of Zion. God is ministering to you. God has remembered your condition. That's your predicament. That's your condition. God is ministering to you today. Go into prayer. and talk to God about your condition. Talk to God about your condition. Don't be like Peter. That Jesus said, do this. And say, I've been doing all this throughout the whole night. Move by the word of God. Don't be saying, I've been saying this prayer for many years. Move with faith. Say the prayers. Claim your justice. Claim your blessing. Claim your victory. God is moving. And Jason is on your voice. God has remembered your condition. God has broken in silence. Today is for you. Don't be like Peter. I've been fishing all night. I've not gotten anything, not even crayfish. Just do what God wants you to do. This moment is for you. This critical moment is for you. God has broken in silence. Miracle is moving on in your family. There will be testimonies and testimonies. For God has broken his silence. God has remembered his family, your family. God is working on your condition. God is no man. God is God. Remember, even Jesus is God-man. He knows how to treat us as a man and how to handle your condition as God. He's equal to the task. Don't lose hope. God is God. God has broken in silence. You have to be alive to see the blessings of God. You have to be alive to receive divine blessing. You have to be alive to see that condition being solved by God. You are looking at your child and you think that he or she will never become somebody. Let me tell you. You think like human. Remember, God says, my ways are not your ways. You may speak your language, but God has not spoken. You have to be alive to see that condition change. Don't die before your time. Don't lose hope. God is with you. Remember, Isaiah 55, verse 10. I will not return until my word has carried out its plan. Keep praying as I minister to you. Come to Jesus. Amen, amen. He will never fail you. Amen, amen. Come to Redeemer. Amen, amen. He will never fail you. Amen, amen. Come to Jesus. Amen, amen. He will never fail you. Amen, amen. Come to Redeemer, amen, amen. He will never fail you, amen, amen. Is that your sickness that is troubling you? Present it before the Lord in prayer. Is that your sickness that has been giving you sleepless nights? Present it before the Lord in prayer. Present it before the Lord in prayer. Oh, come to him in prayer. Oh, come to him in prayer. Oh, he will never fail you. Amen. Come to Jesus, my child. Come to Jesus, my child. All your aches and pains will go away. all your expectations will melt away, oh Lord, I say. Oh, surrender yourself to God. Oh, surrender your pains to God. Oh, surrender your pains to God. Oh, he will take care of you. I say, come to him. I say, come to him. I say, come to you, oh God. He's telling you, come to God with your pain. Come to God with your pain. Oh, he's ready to take care of you. Come to a Redeemer, amen. He will never fail you, amen. Is that your business that is worrying you? I say, bring your business to the Lord. Bring your business to the Lord. Bring your business to the Lord. That the establishment will flourish. That the establishment will flourish. I say, come to Jesus. Come to our Redeemer. He will never fail you. Amen. You have a job. You have a job. Oh, God has kept you alive. God has broken his silence in your condition. God has broken his silence in your condition. I say, come. I say, come. Don't go away. Don't go away. Come to the Lord. I say, come to the Lord. I'll receive your divine blessing. God is talking to you. God is ministering to your condition. Oh, my Lord, I said it, that you receive your divine breakthrough. Come to our Redeemer. Amen, amen. He will never fail you. Amen. Yon kena mag, mokute chine kene mere. Yon kene chugura, mokute chine kene mere. Oh, atunoja. Oh, atunoja wachiku. Atunoja wachiku. Obuya kere wigwe na na ino na o. Asinga atunoja. Oh, do not be afraid, my child. Do not be afraid, my child. Come to Jesus. Come to him. He will never fail you, my child. He created thunder and lightning. He will use it against your enemies. Don't be afraid when the thunder and lightning is broken in. I say, come to Jesus. Come to your God. He will never fail you. Amen. Come to Jesus. He will never fail you. Amen. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. He will never fail you. Amen. Come to my Redeemer. Come to my Redeemer. He will never fail you. Amen. Heavenly Father, I've ministered your word to your people. They're waiting for their divine blessing. They're waiting for their divine grace. You are the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and end of their life. You make a way where there seems to be no way. You have broken your silence. I know that you, my God, has remembered your people. I crave your divine indulgence, O Lord, to shower your divine grace upon them. May they receive your divine breakthrough. May they be able to be aware that you, my God, has remembered them in their predicament, that you have broken your silence. You say you never rest till their conditions are okay. Visit them in their hospital. Visit them in their families. Many people are looking for your divine breakthrough. They don't know where else to go. It is you that can save them, O Lord. I stretch out my hands of Elijah upon you, for you to receive the mantle of blessing and grace. As Elisha received the mantle of blessing and grace. I stretch out my blessings upon you. That the 12 apostles who render their blessings upon you and your family. So that today, God has broken his silence. There will be many good doors opening for you for good job, promotion, business establishment. Your marriage encounter will be that of peace and love and happiness. There will be peace in your family. There will be peace again. Your children will be good children. Enemies will no longer speak ill of his family. Many people will sing your praise. You no longer sing your own praise. For God will use your enemies to raise you up. God will turn around everything to your own good. God has spoken in the Bible. And we claim it in faith. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.